Hello everyone and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. The pen tool inside Affinity Designer is a multifunctional tool with different modes, actions, gestures, and snapping controls. So I will cover these topics and get you ready to draw your next artwork. The first pen tool mode we are going to explore is the line mode. The line mode draws single segment straight lines that self-terminate. So I'm tapping and dragging and creating a bunch of independent straight lines that self-terminate. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete those. Now we can add touch modifiers to control some of these behaviors. So when we start drawing with the line mode, and if we put two fingers on the canvas, we can constrain the movement to 45 degree increments like so. Another gesture is when we start drawing, we can actually add a four finger modifier on the canvas and change the starting point, which will allow us to reposition the line as it has been created. The next pen tool mode we are going to explore is the polygon mode. The polygon mode draws straight lines and shapes with sharp nodes and corners. So I'm going to tap and add a bunch of points here. And specifically, we call those points anchor points. And as you can see here, we have an open path, which means we have a line with two endpoints like so. For the second example, we have a closed path, which is a closed shape with no endpoints. So for that again, I will activate the pen tool and I will add a bunch of anchor points. And I'm actually going to misplace those paths on purpose because I want to show you one of the pen tool snapping controls. Now, because this is a closed path, all we have to do is tap on the very first node to close the path like so. Now for the snapping control I mentioned earlier, I will go ahead and tap on the right arrow in the context toolbar, and I will activate this snapping control, which is called Align to Nodes of Selected Curves. This snapping control will horizontally or vertically align any node you drag to any other node on the same or a different curve. So for that, I will activate the edit mode of the pen tool, and then I will start aligning paths together. The horizontal red line indicates horizontal snapping, and the vertical green line indicates vertical snapping. The next pen tool mode we are going to examine is the pen mode. Here we have a combination of smooth points with corner points. And by the way, a smooth point is a point made up of two linked control handles. So first, tap and drag to create a smooth point with these two linked control handles. Then tap to add a two-finger modifier to constrain the control handles to 45 degree increments. Release the modifiers, and then because the next point is a corner point with no directional handles, all we have to do is to tap once to create one. The upcoming point is a smooth point, so tap and drag to get the two handles out, and then change the direction of one path independently from the other path by tapping a one-finger modifier onto the canvas and change the direction of the control handle. This is known as cusp points, where two control handles are not locked in jaw alignment to each other. Again, we have a corner point with no directional handles, so tap once. The next point is a smooth point, so add a one-finger modifier onto the canvas and change the direction of the handle to create a cusp point and bring this down. So now we will activate the edit mode of the pen tool and edit those points. So I will tap on this node here to bring the control handle right on top of it. And I will do the same for this node as well. And I think that looks pretty good. And as you can see, we have a nice wavy curve. In this example, we have a combination of curves and straight lines. So let us go ahead and see how that works inside Affinity Designer. Still on the pen mode, tap and drag to create a smooth path with two control handles and add a two-finger modifier to keep the handles straight and release. The next point is also a smooth curve, so tap to add a two-finger modifier as you drag to contain the movement to 45-degree increments and draw the curve path. Now, this time, release one finger from the canvas and change the direction of the control handle to create a cusp point as covered on the previous example. The next point is a corner point, so just tap once to create one. Because the next point is a smooth point, tap to get the control handles out, and this time add only one finger modifier instead of a two finger modifier, since the node has previously been added, and keep the control handle straight. Repeat the exact same process for the remaining of the path. Now let us go ahead and edit our curves and straight lines by tapping to activate the edit mode of the pen tool. And also, don't forget to activate the snapping control of the pen tool we used earlier, the align to nodes of selected curves, and edit the paths as previously covered. Now that you are familiar with all the pen tool gestures, let us take a look at another curves with corner points example. Still on the pen mode, tap and drag to create a smooth path with two control handles and add a two-finger modifier to keep the handles straight. Here, I need to change the position of the smooth point, so add a four-finger modifier to move the point where you need, and then release. So next up, a smooth curve, so tap to add a two-finger modifier to constrain the movement to 45-degree increments and draw the curved path. Now use one-finger modifier to change the direction of the control handle and place it right on top of the other handle to change the direction of the upcoming curve. Repeat the same process for the rest of the curved path. The next pen tool mode we are going to examine is the smart mode. The smart mode will automatically create curves for you. Nice, flowing line shapes as smooth as possible. In this case, I will add just three anchor points, one right in the middle of the hard contour shape, one to the right, and one at the bottom. Now I will switch to the edit mode of the pen tool, and notice when I tap on each of the nodes formulating the curve, control handles appear. So in this case, I will first pull out this curve segment, then tap on the first node to adjust the control handle, and do the same to the node across and formulate the curve. I will continue adjusting the curved path by tapping on the bottom node, adjusting its control handle, and repeat that for the one on the right-hand side. Now let's talk about the actions available to manipulate curves. Still in the pen tool mode, I will draw a simple curve with 1, 2, 3, and 4 anchor points. I will tap on the edit mode, and to get to the pen tool actions in the context toolbar, tap on the right arrow, and the first action we're going to look is the break curve. So in this case, let's say I will select this node, and then I will tap on the break action, which removes the curve because it is separating the endpoints. The nodes will be split into two different anchor points, one for this line and one for the other line. And if you want to connect those anchor points back again, just drag one node right on top of the other. Now I'm going to draw two separate paths to demonstrate the join and close curve actions. One here, one there, and then deselect the pen tool. Tap on the pen tool again and draw the other path like so. Inside the layer studio, I will swipe to the right to select both paths. Marquee select the top nodes and then use the join curve action, which connects two separate curves together to make one curve. Then I will close the curve, so I will tap on the close curve action, which joins the start and end nodes to create an enclosed shape. The reverse curves action reverses the direction the curve was drawn in. So I will create a curve path here, and I will tap on the reverse curves to reverse the direction of the path and anchor points. As a result, the start anchor point becomes the end point. The preserve selection when creating new curves mode can be used in conjunction with any other modes. So for example, I will tap and drag to create a curve path, deselect, and select the pen tool again and draw another path. In this case, I cannot see the curves I had previously drawn. So I will delete that. I will activate the preserve selection when creating new curves mode, and I will draw the curve again. This time around, I can see the curves I had previously drawn. I will switch to the edit mode. Select both curves from the Layer Studio. Use the join curves action and drag one node right on top of the other node to create an enclosed shape. Very powerful. The add new curve to selected curves object mode again can be used in conjunction with any other of the other modes, which creates additional curves on the same layer as the initial curve. So I will tap and drag to create the first curve path. And in the context toolbar, I will activate the add new curve to selected curves object mode. Now I will draw another curve. And looking inside the Layer Studio, the second path was drawn in the same layer, and we can see that when we apply a fill color. Thank you everyone for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.